Hello students, welcome to the series of lectures in structural analysis. In the previous lectures we had discussed about the proper cantilever beams and fixed beams. Today we will discuss about the continuous beams. In this continuous beams, when we see a particular beam as a continuous beam means, if the beam is supported on more than two supports. That means, for example, suppose if there is a beam of length some 10 meters, and if it is having an intermediate support at a distance of some 5 meters from one end and 5 meters from the other end. At this case, then we say this beam as a continuous beam. Why? Because this intermediate support, it is dividing these two spans or a single beam into two beams. So, these type of beams we call it as a continuous beams. In this, simply you can say a continuous beam. It is a beam which is supported on more than two supports. Then you can say it as a continuous beam. In this, for example, if you consider a continuous beam, suppose I am considering a continuous beam like this. For this continuous beam, suppose I am considering it is carrying a UDL, uniformly distributed load. For it is possessing certain deflection. Suppose I am taking its deformation like this. Suppose this is support A, this is B, and this is C, and this is D. Okay, these are the types of supports. And if you consider the moments at the supports, it is equal to the zero. At the ends, it is equal to zero. In this, for example, when a beam is subjected to UDL, the deflection curve, it is having convexity upwards over the intermediate supports and concavity upwards over the midspan of the beam. So, in this, if you consider here, in this, you can observe this convexity and concavity natures. The convexity is upwards over the intermediate supports. That means here, at the intermediate supports, the convexity is upwards, whereas at the mid-span, the concavity is upwards. That means the concavity is present upwards at the mid-span of the beam, whereas at the intermediate supports, the convexity is upwards. Whereas at the mid-span, concavity is upwards. So, this will be the difference in this. In this, when you are undergoing with the hogging moments, suppose if you consider the hogging moments, are taken as negative moments, at the intermediate supports. At the intermediate supports, the hogging moments are taken as negative moments. And if you consider the sagging moments, these are considered as positive moments. The sagging moments are considered as positive moments over the mid-span of the beam. In this, if you consider the end supports of a simply supported beam or continuous, it will not be subjected to any bending moment. But the end supports are considered as a fixed continuous beams. That means, for example, I am considering the ends of the continuous beam are fixed and there are some intermediate supports at the ends, at the middle. So, this is B and this is C and this is D. Suppose, for this case, it is also carrying a UDL of same intensity. For this case, what will happen means, the moment at A equal to the moment at D equal to 0. And the moment at A and the moment at D, either it exists, but this will be equal to 0 for this simply supported case. Whereas here you are having a fixed end moments. So, moment at A and moment at D, it exists, but it will not be equal to 0. This will be the condition in this end supports of a simply supported beam conditions. And if you consider this bending moment diagram for a continuous beam, If the moments over the intermediate supports of a continuous beam are known, then only the bending moment diagram can be drawn. If you know the moments at the intermediate supports, are known, then bending moment diagram can be drawn. This is the first case, and for second case, the moments over the intermediate supports, are determinant. That means they can be find out by using equations of equilibrium. Then we can say it as a determinant by using Clapeyron's three moment equation. By using Clapeyron's three moment equation or theorem. From this, you can find out the moments over the intermediate supports. So, first of all, this will be the introduction about the continuous beams. Simply, you can say a beam as a continuous beam if it is having intermediate supports and the beam is having more than two or more spans, then you can say a particular beam as a continuous beam. Hope students, you had understood up to this. Thank you for listening. Please subscribe this channel. Thank you for listening this lectures, and subscribe to YouTube. Thank you.